welcome to the channel. If you are looking to get more of your ideal client, ideal customer, right from the get-go, you need a beautifully designed and also very well thought out lead magnet. This is what we're talking in the channel right now. And in this episode, I'm going to walk you through my process to define what is the ideal aesthetic that is going to please your avatar, as well as how to decide if you should go custom or template. That's my 3-point framework for you to really decide if you're ready for a custom. And also how to design it in Canva, one of my favorite tools, and you're probably very familiar with it. I'm not gonna spend too much time. It's so easy to use, but you gotta know a few tricks. So stick around, this episode is juicy. And if you're looking for even more information, make sure you subscribe, hit the bell. I'm talking all about growing beautiful online businesses in this channel, and you definitely cannot miss anything. Para as minhas pessoas amadas do Brasil, se você não quer perder nadinha desse episódio, coloca a legenda em português que eu traduzo para você, assim você não perde nada, não fica confuso e não tem problemas de tradução, ok? If you're new to the channel, welcome, welcome. I'm Roberta West and I mentor online business entrepreneurs like yourself in how to create a brand experience as well as a solid backbone for your online business. And if you need more behind the scenes and a little bit more about my process, that conversation is happening on Instagram. So make sure you find me at the Roberta West on Instagram. All right, let's be friends there. Okay, in video one, we talked all about how to create a lead magnet that converts, meaning what is the idea, what is the topic that is gonna foster your business, is gonna grow your business, as well as people wanna get. That's the magic, right? You need to find that balance and you need to find what is beneficial for you and for your client. Today we're talking all about the design, but if you wanna go back and watch it, the link is right here. Okay, let's dive right into the design. The first thing you need to decide is what kind of aesthetic your ideal client is gonna be more drawn to. In this time and age, I don't have to tell you that we have about 5 seconds or less to grab our customer's attention, right? So you wanna make sure that whatever aesthetic, whatever identity you create for your lead magnet really hit home for your ideal customers. One simple way I do this is I go on Instagram or I go on social media and I find a few people that I'm really targeting with this lead magnet idea. So for instance, for my tech guide, I went and I followed a few of my friends that are course creators that are just at the beginning stage of creating their course. And I looked at patterns and I looked at what are the people they are following. And especially when they have bigger accounts that they follow, I want you to take a look at what they're liking, what they're commenting. And that's really important so you can see how those brands that they're already engaging with look like. No copying here, please. That is so 2000. We are not copying any brand. We're just getting some hints of what our ideal client is already drawn to. So for instance, let's say my ideal client loves Jenna Kutcher. I'm not gonna go really far away from that brand. I'm gonna build into some of her pillars or some of her identity and bring my own to the mix so I can create something really perfect. Let's say the colors that they're drawn are more neutral, more romantic, like the script. Things of that nature really make the visual come together in a much better way, in a much more credible way for your ICA. So I want you to do this quick exercise. If you have to pause this video, that's totally fine, but I want you to go ahead and kind of stalk your ICA a little bit. Stalk a few people that you think can really profit from your lead magnet, that could really use it, and see who they're actually following. And make some notes, what are those women? Is it a feminine brand? Is it pink? Is it neutrals? Is that more industrial? Find those adjectives and maybe poke around, see who the designers of the brand are, you know, what they're doing. A lot of the brand designers nowadays do have templates for you. So maybe this is a way for you to get that same aesthetic if you connect, if your brand really connects with it for a fraction of a custom service. service. So that's a great tip right there. Go stalk your ICA because you want to see what they see and what they already like and engage with. Okay, the second step to create the perfect lead magnet is to decide if you're going to go with custom or template. I have a three-point strategy for you, a three-point framework, actually, that is going to help you decide whether you should go custom or template. Just bear with me. There is a system to it, and it's not complicated. So the first step is to decide, is your content proven? Meaning, have you already got some feedback? Have you already got some good indication that the topic you're talking about is going to attract your ideal client? If no, I want you to check out the template route because you really don't know if your content is appropriate, if it's the way people want to see this information. For instance, if you are doing a PDF and let's say is a checklist, maybe your ICA is not really looking for a checklist. They're looking for maybe a mini course. And by going the template route, you can troubleshoot and you can check that a lot faster than if you go about creating a full checklist for your brand and not getting any results from it. So definitely, if it's not proven content, I want you to go check out template. Now, if it is, if you got good indications, the second step in the process is to really make sure you have the resources, the time, and the money to create a custom template. That's very important because you know what? In this time and age, obviously, you know, if you spend a month creating this PDF, this is actually a month that you could be investing or you could be putting it out there and getting clients into your list, getting clients into your world, right? The same goes for money. The money you are putting into creating a custom item could be used to do some Facebook ads or grow your community or even invest in other parts of your business. So be very mindful. Do you have the money and time? It would likely run you at least $1,000 depending on the size or the job, and also a good month to go about, you know, finding the right graphic designer, creating the right template, going back and forward with drafts and all of this. So make sure if you don't have the money, check out the templates. We're going to talk about them in a second. If you do have the money and time, the last point I want you to consider is whether or not this is strategic for you. Is it a differentiator in your brand? So for me, the answer is yes. People come to me for my brand, for how it looks. Therefore, everything I do is sort of custom or is on brand. But that's how I get my client. That's what my ICA wants to see. Be very realistic in this step because it's so easy for us to get kind of drawn into the super creative and custom, and not always is the best route for you. So before you go ahead, make sure that this is a strategic differentiator for your brand. And if you're not Coca-Cola, that's totally fine. Go get a template that goes with your brand aesthetic and vision, and I'm giving you the resources in a little bit, all right? And if you decide to go with custom, you go through this three-point analysis and you say, you know what, I'm ready for custom. That's great. We're gonna have a whole video series in a little bit just talking about how to do your custom branding work. So make sure you subscribe. Hit the bell so you don't miss any of those amazing videos I have prepared for you. Okay, so we did a lot of great work this far, and I want to take a break here and ask you in the comments, what is your lead magnet idea? I'm really, really interested to know what you're creating, and maybe we can all pitch in, see how this idea really comes about. So take a minute, put in the comments, what is your lead magnet idea? We really want to know. So now if you are going for a template, right? And this is my recommendation, by the way, there are so many beautiful templates out there. You should definitely start there. If you're going with that, let me show you how I find very beautiful templates or templates that do match my ICA aesthetic. Remember the exercise we just did? So how do I go about finding it on Creative Market? Creative Market has a million designs. So I'm showing you a little bit of a trick to find the right design for you.
To start our lead magnet design process, we're going to pick a template. As you probably know, Canva has a ton of really good free templates. But if you're looking for something a little bit more custom and a little bit more unique, go to Creative Market and type on the search the exact word that you're looking for. So for example, I am creating the workbook that I'm using for this workshop, but you might be looking for a checklist or an ebook or a mini course, whatever you're looking for, try to find it exactly what you are looking in Creative Market, just because there's so many items, you want to find the closest possible. So if you're investing on a template, just quick tips, like try not to get one of those bundles. There's just so much inside. You're going to get lost and discouraged to even go through. So just find one that really catches your eye and you think you can use for a long time. For example, this one here is pretty simple. If you go inside, you get to see the different pages that they already create for you. So if you feel like 80% of those pages you can use in your business, that's a good template to get. It's pretty clean, easy to customize, and the colors, obviously, it's super simple, and I'm gonna show you inside Canva. All right, so pick one that has about 80% of what you want and you can purchase.
All right, so you picked your template, or you are looking for a free template, totally cool. Canva is the place to go. I've used Photoshop and InDesign for years in my business. And I know how hard it can be. So I want to give you a quick tutorial on Canva. By all means, this is a full channel's topic, honestly. And I can give you a few resources on this video description if you want to go even further on your Canva design. I have really great friends that do an amazing work and they can teach you all about it. But I just want to give you a little glimpse of how to find a template and also how to start customizing. It's really, really easy. Let's just jump into my computer and you're gonna see how I do it.
So let's go take a look at what it actually came with so you can see how I customized. Okay, I'm gonna make a copy. It's very hard to just download again to find those things. So once they're in Canva, just make sure that you make a copy for everything. So this is the cover page. You can use it if you want, or you can just find another one. So with this template, I paid a little bit more. I think it was $37 for this, but I really like first the colors. It was everything that I wanted. And then here is what you get. So you get like several pages. I picked this one, as you saw, but they have multiple cover pages that you can use multiple times. Like I can use this template several times. I can change the color here. I'll go on the top, see background color right here. And let's say my colors now are a little bit lighter. Perfect. Now I go here and I'm like, okay, the color now I want is this. See, it looks completely different and it's the same template. You know, maybe your colors now are gray. There you go. Now you have a different cover and you get an image. So to move an image in, you're gonna upload if you don't have it yet and you can put a video too. But let's just say I'm just gonna drop this here. So easy, and you can double click if you want to adjust the photo itself. This one fits pretty well. So this is like an additional cover, for example. You can come here and you can add all your principal colors here, so it's so much easier to adjust. See, that would be another cover for a different freebie, for example. So once you have the template, literally like you can use for multiple items, and there is the copyright, which I put in the back. Here's the welcome page that I used, table of contents that you saw, and this is the first option, or you can start with chapter one. I use both in different ways, or you can do a cover for each chapter. If you're really building a book or something that is massive, I recommend you have a cover for each of them. I didn't think I needed. There are all sorts of different templates. Like this is to put an image. Again, you can just go to your uploads, get any image, say my picture in here. Anyways, I don't think it's like to put my picture, but Studio Lore created all those beautiful pages that you can just plug and play. See how I created like a larger box for my own when you need it. You can modify, you can just reduce, you can move all those pieces for the design. Here's several different quote pages that you can pick from. And this is the closing or the call to action. You know, when you send, you want someone to take some action.
action on what you did. This is where you would go. This is the one I picked with my photo. I like to keep my photo front and center. You could use this one too. There's even this content here that I could put my photo like big and bold. And you would love that. That would be fun. Okay, we can adjust the clip. You can really play around with what you have here. So this is how the original template looked like. As you can see, if you want all different colors, it's very simple. But as a rule of thumb, Canva is going to give you the best result. I just recommend, once again, that you spend some time and find exactly what you need for your freebie. It's just in the past 6 months, there's a lot more being created. You know, if you're doing a checklist or if you're doing a photo album like or whatever you're trying to do, just try to find the template and then you just plug in your content, which you likely already drafted in a Google Drive, and you're ready to go. So now that you have your content and also your design, your lead magnet is ready to be integrated. Integrated is just a fancy word for like putting all the pieces together, the mechanism of delivering your lead magnet to the audience you selected. So don't miss the next two videos. We're gonna talk about how to integrate and also how to promote. That video is amazing. So don't miss, make sure you subscribe, hit the bell, and we're coming with the sequence next. Another great resource I have for you is my tech guide. The tech guide is listed on my description. And if you missed, it's really how I apply templates. So this one, it was my first lead magnet ever to be made with a template that I bought off Creative Market. So you get to see how I applied, how I made it my own. And I also used all stock photos. I have a list of all my favorite shops in there. So grab the tech guide. It's amazing for anybody starting an online business and it will give you a lot of good insight to how to narrow down and curate a brand that you're really proud of. And we are done for now, friends. So I'll see you in a few weeks. See you in the next few weeks. And this is it for